Well, I want to officially welcome you to the Spring 2015 Gracenote Recital! Parents and community, and we just want to say thank you so much for joining us. This is a really, really big deal to these kids. You'll see in blue, who, for all those who are present, got a t-shirt, a free t-shirt and sunglasses, and we're just always looking for ways to bless our kids. And you know, this is the next generation, right? And how many of you know that arts are important to a lot of people, right? Well, that's the reason why we started Gracenote, because we believe just because we're on one side of the city doesn't mean that everybody in this community shouldn't have the opportunity. Because we think that God says that they matter, and many of myself and many of us and our instructors have had opportunities, and we want to make sure that they have the same. And so that's the reason why. If you're wondering why we do this, we don't make anything on this. It costs a lot to do it, but we believe in those young ones. And we believe that they're going to do a great thing in our community. Amen. So again, my name is John Schmackman. I'm the director of Gracenote, and I have Pastor Rob Hutton with me, who's our associate pastor at the Word Community Church. And we just wanted to welcome you all. Thank you so much for joining us. And without further ado, you guys are going to have a blast, okay? Here's the deal. When the classes come up, I want you to, like, lose your mind in applause. Is that a deal? Okay, these kids have poured their heart and soul in it, too. So I want you to do that, and we're going to have a great time. You guys ready for a great time? Okay, awesome. I'd like to have Pastor Rob open us.
Hey, before we pray, I want to say one thing. I want to give it up for Pastor John and all the things that he does. Pray so. Pastor John's instructors have worked tirelessly with the kids, showing their love for the community. And you know, our senior pastor just left today for Cuba. And that's an international mission. But as a church, we're committed to the community and the domestic mission here for Jesus Christ and your children. And I wanted you to know that our community is a mission field, and we are very committed to that, as you can see. So why don't you pray with me now? Father, we just thank you today. We thank you for your presence, Lord, and your spirit which rests upon this place. We ask as this recital proceeds, Lord God, that you be in it. We thank you for the children, Lord God, and all that they've learned and absorbed. And we ask today that they would glorify you as they perform. And Father, we know that your spirit lives here, and have it resonate. Have them see the Jesus in us so the world will know you. And Father, we dedicate this recital to you, and we ask it in Jesus' precious name. And everyone said, yeah. Amen.
Awesome. All right, without further ado, the vocal class.
in a while. Dude, I'd like to feel a smile. Have you even heard him call your friend? To know what Jesus thinks of you, the one who's known as faithful and true, his promises will last beyond the end. Whoa, have you felt this pleasure in a while, walking this life mile after mile, to know the heart of the King? So when fog grows in and blurs the view, a distracting gift from you know who, God's love eclipses everything. Oh, and all the joy that it brings, and the songs that you sing, whether it's dying or up, oh. It's when this life brings you pain, in a storm cloud of rain, there's one thing that will keep you, oh, 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 oh. This is pleasure. In a while, is knowing his love in your lifestyle? Tell me, does the thought even occur? 'Cause when we built on many things, we don't rise up on eagle's wings, but simply strode on a road marked detour. Oh, but by his grace, his warmth arises, since he loves to bring surprise. Soon the old begins to melt away. Oh, it's not religious smoke you feel, his promises will help you heal, and favor brings you out from the grave. And all the joy that it brings, and the songs that you sing, whether it's iron or up, oh. 'Cause when this life brings you pain, in the storm clouds of rain, there's one thing that will keep you, oh, 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 oh. It's his pleasure.
That's what I'm talking about. We're just so proud of the investment of these kids. I mean, they're just blooming. As we're transitioning, I want to make a note to a couple special people that are here. Mr. Toby Waite, Mr. Toby and Steph Waite, the superintendent of Big Creek Schools, is here. And I just want to thank you publicly, brother, for your kindness and being. We just got to go up to the mountains in a field trip about a week ago and take the kids up there. It was amazing, and you'll see that a little bit later. We have Nick Jones, director of Care Fresno, is with us as well, too. Thanks for being here, Nick. Let's see, Cheryl from Allard's here. I can't see. I think we have KKEC is here, right? Great to see you. Carmen Coos right down the street. We just have some wonderful, wonderful partners that are helping us do this. How many know it takes, what does that say? It takes a tribe, right? Village, thank you. Thank you for knowing that stuff. Guys, really, I'll tell you a secret. I'm just an artist trying to be as detailed as possible, okay? But you know what? It's really special when it's really changing lives. You know what I'm saying? I'm a personal a testimony of how art. I remember when I first met with Cheryl from Allard's Art Supply. They've been donating us from the very beginning. When I first met with her about 3 years ago, I walked into her store. She had actually remembered me from music from back in the day, and I just kind of started telling, "Hey, we're doing this crazy idea to use music and arts to impact and mentor kids and youth in Southeast Fresno." And she said, "John, you know, words to me." She said, "John, you don't have to tell me how important arts are. It saved my son. You tell me what you need every semester. You send me a shopping list, and I'll hook you up." And guess what? Every semester she's done. We send her a shopping list, and they hook us up. To me, that's not little, but it takes everybody paying it forward. It takes everybody paying it forward. So we're just really, really thankful.
So for this song, the Hey Ya song, I'm sure many of you have heard it, we're going to need a little bit of crowd participation in this. Some people had some Polaroid pictures, so there's going to be a part where we're going to say, shake it like a Polaroid picture. So we want to see all of the audience shake those Polaroid pictures.
How many
pictures.
Of you found a Polaroid picture on
right
your
here,
seat?
Right here.
All right, you're about to clap your hands, all right? I don't need you to see you go crazy.
Yeah.
further ado, we now have a pretty special arts presentation led by our art instructor, Art Sanchez.
Concept we can do that kind of symbolizes how we feel maybe about community, how we feel about God's love, how we feel about loving each other. And I'm pretty proud of these ones because the kids pretty much came up with these on their own. And I just kind of guided them. They painted all the stuff. I cleaned a little bit of it up. And basically, yeah, the painting on this one right here, as you can see, it's kind of dark and empty on the left-hand side. And it's real bright and colorful on the right-hand side. And the meaning behind that was that we have to be the light in our communities to change it, to brighten it up. As you can tell, it's one street. And on this, and you know, both sides of the street, it's two different things. And we really wanted to capture an image that kind of talked to us, you know, cleaning up our own communities, our neighborhoods, helping each other out in our own communities. And doing that, and you can see the light kind of creeping from the one side and getting to the other. The painting on this side, I'm really proud of. I wish he was here. I was asking one of my students, Nathan. I was asking him, "Hey, you know how?" Well, I was asking all the students, "How can we help each other? You know, like what kind of things can we do to help each other in our community?" And he kind of just came to me and was like, "Hey, we can help each other when we're down and out. If we're hurting, we can lift each other up." So I said, "You have an idea?" And he was like, "Yeah." So I said, "Well, then go paint it." And he took one guy with him, and they started knocking it out. And that's the final product right there. Yeah, so super proud of those paintings. The one in the middle is just we basically took these colors you see inside the letters and let the kids throw their hands all over them. And I just went home and cleaned it up. I had to do something. I had that itch, I had that can in my hand, and I had to be like, I gotta get some graffiti in here somewhere. Let me do something. So I just wanted to do something to represent all of us. All the instructors, all the kids got their hands on here. And yeah, so that's pretty much our whole semester wrapped up. Three canvases right here. I hope you guys enjoy it.
Before they leave, do you guys wanna hold them up just so people can see again? We got that? Look at these biceps. Dylan, way to go, man. Lily, you're the real deal, girl. You're the real deal. We are so fortunate, and I do want to, not only are these amazing, this is the entire semester TLC invested week in and week out, and this is extraordinary product. I also want to give a huge shout out to my dear friend, Art Sanchez. He is literally like a magnet for these kids. You also see he has started a mural that we're commissioning along this side. It's going to be telling the good news of God through art form, and Art is the one who's doing that. He's a phenomenal artist, as you can see, and he not only talented, he's bringing it out of these students.
And so I just want to honor you again and tell you how thankful I am for all you do. It's really, really amazing. The art class, and Mr. Art was also gracious enough. This is the first time we've ever done this, but any of these move you, we have two of the canvases in the fellowship hall, and this year, if any of them move you, we are opening them up for a $200 donation. You can actually take them home. The money's going to go right back into the into Gracenote to help us keep changing kids, but this is the first time we're going to offer that up to you. So, I mean, goodness, look at a street, one size dark, one size light. How much does that reflect our city? These are kids painting this beautiful concept. And this year, Art can attest to this, as he mentioned, this is the first year they literally storyboarded. I mean, this was their ideas. It's one thing for him to be the mastermind. This was their ideas that got fleshed out. This, oh my gosh, I mean, it speaks for itself. This is what we're doing in Gracenote, and this art is representing it. That deserves a huge round of applause. One more time. We can just set up inside. So you guys can see it the other time. How great was that? Was that awesome?
Yeah.
That being said, I'd like to invite Nick Jones, Executive Director of Care Fresno. Come join us. My good friend Alicia Clark in the back, leading the Inspire One amazing art program in Viola and in our community. We got some ninjas in the house today, people. Some ninjas. Great to have you, brother.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
You enjoying everything?
Yeah.
Good. Yeah, I've been fortunate to be a part of this with John for, what are we at here?
4 years.
4 years now. This bloomed out of our time together here at the Word. Care Fresno's main goal is to get the Church of Fresno engaged into large apartment complexes, needier neighborhoods throughout the city. We work from everywhere from Southeast to West Fresno, and this is the greatest example of that. Our goal is to get the church to not just come out and give stuff to kids and leave. Our goal is to get the kids involved with people from the church, to bring resources, people, mentors, and God into every neighborhood that we go into, and have it stay, and have it be long-term, like 4 years at least. You know, and so what I think is so impactful of this is when we do this with churches like the Word, like John, we get them to say, what are we good at? What do we already have that we can bring to the community? And that we can be a part of with the people that are there and not just doing to the people that are there. And that's what is awesome about this. As I watch Gracenote and I sit back, I see a whole lot of talented people giving to the kids, but then I see the kids giving back through their music and through their time and their effort and the parents giving back. And that's what I love about all this. When I look at this paper that John's made up and the team's made up here, I see 20 names of people who have not been paid, but have said, I'm going to go use what God's given me to go know people, share what I have, and let them share back over the long term. And so the greatest gift here is not simply the music, but it's the people and the relationships that are being formed with the kids and the leaders here. And that's the end goal of all this. How do we get people together, mentoring, loving one another, and growing each other in their giftings? And that's what we're watching here, and it's pretty special. So guys, just keep getting your kids engaged. Encourage them to keep getting engaged, because this is going to be something they remember, not simply because of the instruments in their hands, but the instruments which God is using, these people that are here.
It really is a really special, special thing. And it's one life at a time. I also want to say, if your kids have benefited from this, as we continue to expand by God's grace, we're going to start our fall semester again, mid-September, looking like September 15th, and that's when we open up enrollment. It's only $10 for the entire semester. We made it 99% off for a reason, because we want to change kids' lives, and that's why we're doing this. So if you got kids between 4th and 12th grade who could benefit from this, especially in this in our community, wouldn't have the opportunity. This is what Gracenote is for. Without further ado, I would love to invite a dear friend of mine who we've been friends for about, I would say, a year and a half, if not 2 years, and I've got to share with him for the last longest about all the great updates, what's happened with Gracenote, and now he gets to be our special guest. He's an amazing hip-hop artist, done probably 7 CDs. We've got to collab on several of them. My good friend, Mr. 17.
Thank you. I was telling him in the back, I said, you know, John absolutely raves about Gracenote. Every time we get together, he talks about Gracenote. He's been trying to recruit me for like a year and a half. I'm like, man, I can't get over there, bro, I'm working. But he's like, no, man, I'm serious. God is doing something in Gracenote. And I'm going to tell you, just watching back there, I walked in and I just kind of sat in the back and I was observing. And you could see the joy on their faces. As they're breakdancing, popping in the mirror, they're having a good time. Their lives are being impacted by God through this ministry. It's absolutely taking place. And I can see it. And if anybody takes the time to really look, you'll see it. These kids, they're going to remember this for the rest of their lives. So when John asked me to be a part, I was like, John, I'll do anything, man, for the next generation. Because that next generation used to be me. Somebody took the time to drive an hour and a half out of their schedule to pick me up and take me to youth group. They would take the time to invest in me when I didn't invest in myself. And it absolutely impacted my life. So in thinking about what to share today, I want to talk to you about your worth. Because your worth is everything. How you view yourself and how you perceive yourself is absolutely everything. And these teachers and instructors are putting value into the youth. They're making them believe that they're worth something more than their surroundings are telling them they're worth. Because when I was growing up in the hood and my father was slinging drugs and I'd open up the freezer and I'd see just pound sacks of weed, that made me tell me what my worth was. But the moment somebody started taking me to church and telling me there was a better way of life, I started seeing myself different than what that was telling me I was. You see, if that's all I had, I would have fell right into the footsteps and been a drug dealer. If that's all I had, I'd have been a drug addict. I'd have been in and out of prison. I would have ended up like my cousin who ended up being burned alive or was still in a dime sack. But God had a different plan. You see, you are worth more than what your environment says you are. And the fact that ministries like this exist shows that not only, because they don't get paid to do it. They don't get paid. You got to hear that. They don't get paid. It'd be easy if they was getting a salary. Be like, yeah, they got other reasons. No, because someone did that for them. And now it's happening for you. And you need to realize that is the love of God. And when my pastor, my youth pastor, would pick me up, it was the love of God. I would trip out. I'd be like, why is this dude driving 45 minutes to get me to go to church? And then all the way back, he'd tell me how many plans God had for me and how much of a good kid I was. And I'd go home and all I'd get was mom yelling at me. Listen. God is putting that value in you. He's putting it in you. When your brothers and your sisters are telling you you'll never amount to anything, Gracenote is telling you something else. That's the love of God. I used to think that I was created for something else. I used to think I was created for nothing. I used to think that I was created and that I would never be anything else other than what my environment told me. But I want to tell you today, you were created to be remarkable.
Amen.
I was created to be remarkable. And sometimes when you hear that statement, you think of that word remarkable. How can I say that? Because isn't that boasting? No, that's the truth. When God put it in you, the ability to heal if you got cut, that's remarkable. Your very flesh says how remarkable you are. Because when you get sick and bedridden, all of a sudden your immune system starts to fight back. That's remarkable. You are made for more than what your environment is saying you are. You are made to be remarkable. And I just want everybody to take a moment and say that. Say, I am remarkable. Let that sink in. You feel that? Do you feel that? Because I feel that. Say it again. Say, I am remarkable. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm good. Let's go. You want to do it?
I say we do it.
Let's do it. What's up?
17 and I, about 5 months ago, simply got to drop a project and a music video, and we thought we'd reinforce the fact that we're made to be remarkable. You all right with that? Let's do it.
Let's do it. This is what you're not. That is what you are.
I was made to be remarkable.
When my take is unending, the odds are against me.
okay to be victorious, victorious. And as short as I breathe, I know that everything inside of me is saying that I'm destined to be, but to be remarkable. Every single cell of my body was put here with a purpose. And every single choice that I make with a certain. Planning mine like a pantomime, my gestures so I'm mesmerized. Anytime I study this great design and I search. Inside I got a power that came from God and it's working. And it sets me free, but don't say I'm undeserving. I'm a waste of time, I ain't worth it. But that's a lie that's so surface. I'm going deep to keep learning, got this fire hot to keep burning.
Two eyes to see, two ears to hear, and a heart that beats. Temptation chasing after every one of these.
Somehow this will bring out the very best in me. What a recipe, when my take is only ended. The odds are against me, my back's to the ropes. And the statistics are staggering, but I can't deny it. The voice that I'm hearing, and it keeps on saying, saying that I was made to be remarkable. My faith is bigger than the mountain that stands against me. And my passion's greater than the doubt that tries to tempt me. And when the storm comes rolling in and all hope gets swept by the violent wind, I know that I was made and built for this, it won't wreck me. Inside I got a power that came from God that won't let me settle for thoughts that keep saying I'm weak and I'm bending. My life is over, it's ending. But that ain't true cause I'm trending upon a path that I'll finish. Gotta keep an attitude that's relentless.
Test the strength of every one of these.
But the only way to know the taste of victory is to know defeat.
When my take is unending, the odds are against me. My back's to the ropes and the statistics are staggering. But I can't deny it, the voice that I'm hearing. And it keeps on saying, saying that I was made to be remarkable.
Turn your attention to the screens to soak up some more remarkable ones.
Fly, fly.
ourselves. Somewhere we live inside.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. You know, I'll tell you a quick story. One of our kids told me one time, this was earlier before, they were sharing, he's like, you know what, Mr. John, I've been to the mountains like four or five times. I was like, well, that's awesome. What he meant by that when I asked him, I said, where'd you go? What he meant was that is he had actually driven through the grapevine before. But what he said, but you know what? He said, the only time I've ever stopped is with Gracenote. The only time I've ever gotten outside of the car, smelled the trees, hiked to see a waterfall, went bowling in the mountains, all kinds of crazy things. We got to do pottery. The only time that ever happened in my life, and he's in high school, was with Gracenote. I think that's special, right? I think it's pretty special. Well, speaking of special, we got the guitar class about ready to rock. You all right with that? What you're gonna have to do is a favor and put your hands together for this one. See?
Oh, somewhere up the mountain. medicine men have a second try. Maybe we've been living with our eyes half open. Maybe we're bent and broken.
Continuation School for Fresno County Office of Education last spring, the beginning of last spring. And he has tremendous vocals, and he is becoming a shining star, not only handling his personal life, working towards graduation, and now thinking about college. And I'm just so proud of him. So this is going to be a special gift. And in addition to, so without further ado, I'd love to introduce Mr. Dale Jouett on an amazing song we'll share in a second. This song is a beautiful a song by Boyz II Men years ago, and it's a shout out. I'm gonna let him drop it, but we also want to honor another mom. Miss Rosemary, it is her birthday today, Savannah's mom. And so we hope that all the moms, Daryl's, Rosemary, and mom are blessed today.
Girl in my life for all time.
my student right there, and I'm so proud of him. I've been trying to get him to get off the stage all semester, and he comes up, he goes, I'm actually going to need the wireless mic. I got a surprise. So I'm so proud of this guy right now. All right, well, now we've got a couple of our girls. Damaris and Alexis, go ahead and come on out, girls. Give it up for Damaris and Alexis.
Those kids did amazing. And because a really talented person with a huge heart poured their life into them all semester, I watched it with my own eyes. There's things I can't even tell you that are miracles in what you just saw. Miracles. How cool is that? Without further ado, I'd like to invite up the Hip Hop Beach Class under instruction with Mr. Ethan Castro, Lionel Taylor. Come on out, folks.
Yo, what's up? You guys having a good time? Yes, yes. My name is Lionel Taylor, and I am one of the instructors for the Hip Hop Beats class, Hip Hop Beats crew for Gracenote 2015. And so what I wanted to do before we kind of get started with what we were going to do is I want to have a little Q&A, question and answer for the kids here, okay? So I want to start with Samantha. She's the shyest one in the group, so we're going to ask her to step out a little bit. Come on. She's the shyest one. We call her the Mark Ronson. She does a lot of the work, but she doesn't want to be in front of the cameras. So it's good she has a camera right here looking at her. So, Samantha, from what you've learned this semester, what are the typical components of a typical song?
Four components, which are a verse, a pre-chorus, a chorus, and a bridge.
Did you guys hear it?
Chorus, pre-chorus, chorus, and a bridge.
Don't say it again. Say it.
There's a verse, a pre-chorus, a chorus, and a bridge.
Yes. Everybody knows those are? All right. That's good. Okay. Next is our pop star, our dancer, Aunt Andrea. Come on out. You guys will see it later on. She's a pop star. In a minute. Trust me. All right. So, since we're talking about pop stars, who's your famous? Oh, your favorite performing artist?
Taylor Swift.
Yes, Taylor Swift. We got any Taylor Swift lovers out here? I'm one. I like her. I'm not afraid to admit it. Okay. And then also, we have another question for you. What's the difference between a songwriter or arranger and a performing artist?
A songwriter and arranger is a person that writes the songs and makes them, and a performer is the person that performs the songs.
Go, girl!
Yeah, I was talking about Taylor Swift. She does both, but not many people do both, right? We have some that are performers and some that are songwriters. Okay, and Maya. She's another shy one. She's a quiet one. She's going to break dance for you guys later. All right, Maya. So, just what did you like most about being in the Hip Hop Beach?
I like Hip Hop Beach because we got to record and learn about the pre-chorus.
We got to record and learn about the pre-chorus, which is what Samantha was talking about, one of the components of the song. Thank you. And the performance and is going to come later from a recording that we did. Thank you very much. And we have two more people coming up. But before we have the last person, which is Savannah, coming up, we actually have a hip-hop artist that is soon to be better than me that is in our group. His name is Tyrese. So instead of asking a question, I asked him if he will kind of show you guys a little something that he does. You guys cool with that?
Yeah.
That's cool? All right, go ahead.
My words are the definition of bars. My unconditional love for rap is taking me far, purposely taking the fall for imperfections and all, creating personal laws for indestructible flaws. And if you think this poetry kills the lyrics and all, the nearest to bitterness is the ignorance of them all.
Yes, you guys can see a little more than that later. Okay, so we are trying to bring something up on the... Okay, we got to get Savannah up here. Come on, Savannah. All right. This is a little sample of our beat. Okay, so... Yeah. Ready? All right, so from that what we made, from that what you guys heard... That was a little drum pattern and synth sound. How did we make this? How did we go about making this?
We brought together the layers of pre-recorded audio sounds and put them together.
There we go. You guys hear that? Yes. Yes. All right. So
yes, you guys get ready to get down? You guys get ready to get down? And we wanted to see if we can get the vocal class to come on up with us too. They've been practicing with us for the last like 5, 6, or 7 weeks. And we wanted to put on a big show for you guys. So we thought it'd be good to have a mob of people. There they go right there. There they go right there.
do a instructor presentation at this point. And because I keep saying you guys are amazing, and you know they must be amazing if these kids can be so amazing, but I'd love to show, love to just let them rock a little bit. So some of our instructors got together and going to do a wonderful song, a little bit of the heart and soul why we do what we do.
Drop this bomb of talent on top of us. I don't know if you guys saw the guys that have been in like every single performance here, but we just got a bomb of talent, and I am so thankful for the guys that joined our dance class. When you see them perform, just know that I couldn't dance at the beginning of the semester. I was in a car accident, and God just blessed me with Jamal, Tyrese, and Moselle. And they came in and choreographed a lot of the dance because I couldn't even move. So when you see this, just give it up to them because they are amazing. And like John said, I am leaving. This is my last semester. But I am just so incredibly thankful for this opportunity. So just give it up for the dance class.
This whole semester, and at this point we are going to give out certificates of completion for every one of the students, and I want you to go crazy. Want to do, I'd first like to call up Mr. Art Sanchez. And all the art class, come forward, y'all. The first one I'd like to do is way to go, Marlins. Yeah, I think we had about 9 of the kids in the class making this beautiful art, but these are those representing. But first, I'd like to give a certificate from my behalf to our wonderful instructor, Mr. Art Sanchez. All right, and next up, I want you to go crazy, Mr. Dylan Israel.
Next up, we have
Lily Godfrey. And last but not least, Samuel Blanco.
One more shout out for the art class, spring 2015. Oh, you guys can go take a seat, and we're gonna end with a big, huge picture. I'd like to bring up the dance class under instruction with Miss Jamina and Miss Yvonne. So I'll just hand them out. You can.
I do want to say one more thing. If my mom could stand up, every semester my mom's daycare, Better Choice Preschool, donates outfits for the dancers. This semester, she donated these sunglasses that you see everybody. Has on, so I just thank you, Mom, for supporting me throughout everything. Alright, so our first dancer we have is Jamal Brown. He actually did a lot of choreography. This guy was a lifesaver for me this semester. I was just like, can you do that? Can you do that? He could, which is awesome. And so next we have Alyssa Lopez. She was just an amazing dancer. She came in and I didn't think she'd be able to keep up, but she came in and just rocked it. All of our girls did. Then we have Angelie Israel. She's our smallest one. But she rocks it too. She keeps up with all these big kids. Alexandria Kazarian. I've been trying to get her in this class for the past 3 semesters and I finally got Alexandria here. And then last but not least, we have Mazel. He's our little firebomb. Big firebomb. So thank you, everybody.
For these two walk away, I would like, you guys already know, I already said a little bit about Miss Jamina, but she has helped not only change these kids, but also been a huge part of Gracenote. One huge round of applause for Miss Jamina Hacker. And then flanking her, if she is Batman, this is Robin, Mrs. Yvonne Herrera. One more shout out for the dance class. Spring 2015. I'd like to bring out the guitar class under instruction by Mr. Jason Dietmeyer and Mr. Cole Elliott. Give them some love, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Jason, you can give it out to him.
Alright, first we got Mauricio Avila. This guy's been rocking the electric guitar this semester. Alright, next we got Kumong Vang. Alright, and then Jennifer Martinez. We got a couple others who've been with us this semester, but I thought I saw one of you guys. I saw Abraham. Where's Abraham? Hey, there's Abraham.
Abraham, hide him out. Is that an army hat? That's awesome. Something. Before you guys walk away, again, I can't even really express my gratitude. When you step out in something and it's way over your head and you know you're going to drown unless God does a miracle and sends a bunch of talented army who wants to pour their lives in the kids for nothing. And when you're also a professional artist and know that usually that never happens. Yeah. When they come, you're so humbled. So my dear brother, Jason Dietmeyer, please give it up. And flanking him, the Batman to the Robin, Mr. Cole Elliott. He informed me he is much cooler than Robin. So we got 2 Batmans up in the house, you guys. All right, let's bring the next of the hip-hop beats class. Come please join us under the instruction by Mr. Ethan Castro, Mr. Lionel Taylor, Mr. John Bunch. Where's D-Rock? Is he coming too? Pastor Dwayne Coleman in the house, yeah. And there are a lot of people wearing shades, but only some people can wear it like that. Oh, yeah. You know what I mean? Dwayne Coleman is actually our youth pastor at the Word Community Church and a gem of a brother. Gem of a brother.
All right, let's see. Mr. DJ Energy, you got more energy than anybody else, so why don't you be the mic? That's real talk. I mean, this is what it is.
What's up, everybody? How y'all doing? So we had a huge talented class with us, and I mean, the amount of stuff and information we threw at them, what they told you up here was like just scratching the surface. That was just a tiny, tiny little tip of the iceberg of what we got into with these kids. They picked up like super advanced topics like a wave envelope for the audio files, granular synthesis. I mean, I just learned that last year in college, and they're picking it up because they're like sponges with their brains. So super glad of this class, super impressed by every single one of you, and you all brought it tonight. Today. So big round of applause. All right, so first up, we have Miss Savannah Hayes. You're the photographer, like, and convincing. Okay, good. All right, we have Miss Samantha Garcia. Miss Mark Ronson. There's no camera. I'm just doing this for fun. And then this is the dear sister of one of our instructors, Miss Maya Bunch.
Oh, yeah.
So proud of her. And we have Miss Andrea Murillo. I think we have a couple more, right? We have Mr. Tyrese, right? Let's give it up for Tyrese! There he is! There's the family. He's gonna do this after me, and he's gonna be able to do so much in the future. This guy is such a talented guy, a great mentor, and has been a fatherly figure to us and these kids, and a huge mentoring guidance in this class. Mr. Lionel Taylor. And then we have The Rock, the stud. He actually ripped out The Rock for when he goes on TV because he's a personal trainer himself. You guys may know him as the G, the man, the action, but we call him as John Bunch. What up, Bunchy? That's my brother. And then we have the spirit of the Hip Hop Beats crew. We have the guy, the man, the mystery, the sometimes ghost, Mr. Dwayne. Oh, man. D-Rock!
And then this guy can't introduce himself. I told you we had talented people. Mr. Ethan Castro just graduated from Fresno State University with his music degree in music composition. Yeah, a professional. We are so blessed. I think it's been, what, 2 years? 2.5, 3 years? Gracenote has been hugely blessed by you. Thanks, man. We love you. Mr. Ethan Castro, ladies and gentlemen. One more time for the Hip Hop Beats class. I'd like to invite the keyboard class with Miss Jasmine Davis and her entourage. Come on, give us some love, people. I think we have like 15 keyboards up here. All right, awesome. Why don't you be the one who hands them out. Let's see, first off, we have, where's Chua Chua? Is she here? Chua Chua Vang. Yes. Up next, we have Miss Saren Tamayo. Is Irina here? Irina Avila! We got the life of the party, Mr. AJ Cervantes! See, I want to give the round of applause for Mr. Suki Miller. Yeah, you going out. I've been working on my mom, by the way. It's Suki. Okay, just in case. Did I get it right? He said kind of. He's like, thanks for flattering me, bro. Okay, Miss Jasmine, would like to say something real quick.
I just want to say thank you to Gracenote for actually allowing me to be an instructor to these awesome kids. I came in at the this is my first semester, but at the last minute, and John and Gracenote and the instructors and the kids have been welcoming with their open arms, and I want to thank you guys, and I really appreciate it. Thank you to Gracenote.
Thank you. Let's see. I want to give a... And I am very grateful for the investment of all that this lady did in the midst of all kinds of things. Miss Jasmine Davis. One more big round of applause for the keyboard class. Last but not least, we'd like the vocal class to come up, please, under the instruction of Miss Sarah Parsons. Here's the deal. We should just introduce Viviana Hernandez. Who is amazing and came on the last week and a half because she's basically been the original gangster of Gracenote. So we love you. She literally came to our field trip, learned the songs, and I said, hey, you're awesome. You've done every semester but this, so join us. So she's wonderful. Miss Sarah, where you at? You can...
All right, well, I gotta say, first of all, how proud I am of these kids. And one thing that's really cool about that, actually, though, is one thing we really focused on this semester was vocal performance. Not just, you know, the craft and the art of singing, but also how to own the stage, right, you guys? And that's why I'm like this guy. So proud of this guy. So I wanna give a huge hand for my class here. Now, this girl, I am so, so, so proud of. She has really come out of her shell. My husband even said so, too, Damaris. Damaris Blanco, I'm so proud of you. All right, and Heaven, Miss Heaven. Beautiful little Heaven, she's such a joy. She's got the sweetest hair, we love having her. Daryl Jewett, man, this guy.
Another one, we could just say, Miss Sarah Parsons, she's going to bring a spark to the world, and she has been since joining us the last number of semesters. So thankful for all you do. Miss Sarah Parsons! So, thank you guys for hanging in there. I'd like to invite every blue shirt up on this stage. We're going to take a huge photo op, if you guys are right with that.
Some of you can be right there.